Hello everyone, my name is Ipshita and I'm currently pursuing my Master's in English Literature from Calcutta University. If you have clicked on this video, I am assuming that you want one of this first class degree certificate and an A+ result in graduation. So I request you to watch till the end, as I have talked about mark scheme, exam, scholarship and expected percentage in detail.
Here's a preface of my video, watch by your preference.
So without further ado, let's get into the video. First and foremost thing you must do is get yourself acquainted with the mark scheme, because high chances are your honors course may not provide you high percentage of 80-90% as you used to get in boards. Like in English Literature honors, so getting over 50% is a task, and 55% is the maximum eligibility criteria for any further studies like masters in India, and 60% is the standard to get a first class degree. Obviously, it differs from subject to subject.
And I aim for marks above 60.
Now that you know how much to score to get A+ degree, let's talk about how to achieve that goal. Okay, so starting off with the syllabus, which will be a whole lot in any honors and which we can't deny. Completely new pattern, new terms, types, meter, rhyme, definitions, quotations, learning all of that at a time might be a bit tedious, and this infinite amount of study you have to do, but a little is actually asked in exams. You read like thick fat books, but only 6 to 8 questions come in exams. So important thing is to have a sense of categorization, that some and which topics are more important than the other. And how will you be able to categorize? Thus coming to my next point. Get hold of and solve as much as previous year questions. I have probably talked this in my previous study with me video as well, but this is vital to be able to tactically choose the modules and understand the mark division and question pattern. You will have this sense of idea that okay, this text comes in or an alternative of this particular text. So maybe in these 4 subjects, if you thoroughly go through only 2 subjects, you will be good to go. This is where you reduce your syllabus for yourself and play smartly. Yes, work on writing answers. Brush up your sentence structure and enrich your vocabulary. Try to input as much information and knowledge, but precisely in your answers, because ultimately your answer in exam will speak your ability. And I have talked to my teachers about this previously as well, who themselves check papers, that what is the highest number that they give to any student. A reply was in 15 mark question. If the answer is very top class also, they give maximum 10 to minimum 7, and in 5 marks that range limits between 3 to 3.5 something, and that's the reason why scoring above only 50% gets very difficult. This might sound a bit obvious, but try not to alienate yourself from college entirely. Try to attend lectures, because college flies by and you won't be able to catch up with the studies if you don't follow. And trust me, if you mess up in first sem or year, it's really hard to make up the first class target then, because it's a long process starting from the day 1 to the day of results. And mostly, ask to teachers about doubts. In college, teachers are more liberal and friendly to you, unlike in school. What I did was, I used to write answers and get those corrected from teachers to get a clear idea and to get flaws of my answers checked. Well, why should only teachers chase you giving assignments and homeworks? Instead, why not us students chase them with our answer scripts? We human beings are very fond to get gifts, and after any accomplishment, that reward back is indeed very satisfying and motivating. Obviously, the degree certificate is the best reward back for any student who is investing their smart work, dedication and commitment until results. But many state universities have their own scholarship scheme to reward students if they surpass their certain required percentage marks, which usually is about 55%, and that amount is quite offering. I can't actually name the scholarship names of other states, but here in West Bengal we have Vivekananda Merit Kam Scholarship and so on. Talk to friends, batchmates, make group sessions. We actually happen to remember any topic longer if we discuss it with others, unlike just reading passively and memorizing. Chances are your friend might have an overall different interpretation and perspective than yours. Also, they might pop up with a question which you don't happen to know, and to search that particular question, you may delve much deeper into the subject and understand most out of it. So, help each other growing. Also, you may ask seniors about any doubts because they were in the same situation as yours and they will understand you much better. Also, feel free to ask me about any queries in comments. I will be happy to help you answering. And about getting first class honors, first, let's develop a healthy mindset that competition is only and only with yourself and not with others. Improve yourself day by day. Stay focused, study wisely, and you know what? I believe in you. You can get that A+ degree certificate for yourself too. All the best and bye-bye.